Hello everyone, welcome back to Spectrum Classes. This is our second video on the topic of metallurgy. In this video, we are going to discuss the important ores of different metals. And we are going to discuss these ores with their mnemonics so that it will be easy for you to memorize these ores. First, we are going to discuss that metals are found in combined form of their oxides, sulfides, sulfates, carbonates, and halides. And metals are based on their reactivity categorized in 5 different forms and their combinations with the chloride, sulfates, carbonates and bicarbonates. But it is very difficult for us to memorize all such things. In the previous video, we have already discussed that what is the reason of these metals to form their chloride, sulfates, carbonates and bicarbonates are as, since these alkali metals and alkali earth metals, as the name suggests, they are basic in nature and therefore they react readily with the acids. And as we know, we are having 3 different mineral acids, and apart from that, since carbon dioxide is present in blandissime amount in atmosphere, that on combination with rainwater forms carbonic acid. That is why we in nature we are having metal carbonates and their bicarbonates. Metals on combination with the different anions, they form their minerals, and those minerals which are having high concentration of metals in them so that it is economically viable to extract the metals from those minerals are termed as ores. So these all terms we have already defined in our previous video. And here in this video, we are going to discuss the different important ores of the metals and their mnemonic so that we can understand or we can memorize for it our exam point of. First, we are going to memorize the metals and their ores as per the reactivity series. So in the reactivity series, potassium and sodium are placed first as alkali metals. So these alkali metals and their ores and chemical formula of these ores are summarized over here. So the mnemonics to memorize these ores for sodium and potassium are, I have made this sentence, and from their first letter we are going to have the idea about their names, right? So relate VP with sodium constant. So from this sentence we will come to know that we are going to discuss about the ores of the sodium. So this R relates with the rock salt. Then BP, V of this BP is for borax, with W relates with the washing soda. So here is sodium. So sodium stands for soda ash. Here I have mentioned concentration, so you can either way you can memorize this either with the sodium concentration or sodium and chili salt bit. So here how you are going to memorize this, relate rock salt before borax, W washing soda, soda ash, and thereafter chili salt pit. So in this way you can memorize the ores of sodium. And for potassium, potassium is suggested now, either you can write down in this manner or potassium for Selwyn Knighter. Suppose Selwyn Knighter is a person with its first name and second name. Through this we are having this one, soda ash, chili salt petrol, Selwyn Knighter. These 4 ores are directly from their names, and we also know this is for sodium and this is for potassium. How you are going to memorize these chemical formula? So some you need to remember and some you can relate. Rock salt, we are very much familiar with the chemical formula of this, or otherwise you can memorize this. Borax, this again you have to memorize. Washing soda and soda ash, both are related with the carbonates. So sodium carbonate, sodium carbonate. Only the difference is washing soda is 10 hydrated. So you can relate this. For washing, we need water. So washing soda, soda ash. And soda ash is sodium carbonate. Washing soda, sodium carbonate with water. Chili saltpeter and nitre. Saltpeter only, this is chili salt. These 2 are nitrates, right? And Selwyn stands for potassium chloride. The next is magnesium and calcium. These are our alkaline earth metals. So what is alkaline earth metals? As you know, magnesium and calcium, since these are found in earth crust. For magnesium, I use this sentence, And I try to rhyme this sentence with the very famous nursery rhyme, that is, O MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. So from there I try to rhyme, maybe it works or not. MacDollum's Epsom car. So magnetite, and this is related to the magnesium ore, right? So first mag, so MacDollum's, dolema, Epsom salt, carnelite, carnelite, right? So magnesite is magnesium carbonate. Dolomite, how you are going to remember this? So double the salt, magnesium carbonate is there, you just double the salt. So magnesium carbonate in combination with calcium. Epsom salt, so from S we are getting some idea about the sulfate. So magnesium sulfate, 7H2O. Carnelite, so C or L, both are present in this. So magnesium chloride, potassium chloride and 6H. You can relate somewhat, not exactly. And the next is calcium. So for calcium, I have used this sentence. Calcium ores, limestone and gypsum. Fluorspar. Here limestone, also this is also known as calcite, then gypsum, then fluorspar. So here is calcium fluoride. So you just try to remember this, because in the next slide we are having almost similar name. So here we are having fluorspar, and in the next slide we are having feldspar for aluminium ore. So these two are having almost same name. So here limestone, you are very much familiar with this, calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate or this limestone is used in cement industry heavily. The next one is calcium sulfate dihydrated. If we are having this half hydrated, then that is termed as POP. So this gypsum is used to make POP, or that is plaster of Paris. So you can relate that. That is why I have write this sentence like this. So these things, if we relate with the other terms, we can have better understanding. So here limestone, which is also known as calcite, has formula calcium carbonate, and this calcium carbonate is heavily used in cement industry. Then gypsum is calcium sulfate dihydrated, and if it is half hydrated, then that is termed as POP or plaster of Paris. And here we are having calcium fluoride. So what you have seen here is the salts of carbonates, sulfates, fluorides, again carbonates, sulfates and fluoride. So alkaline earth metals are present in the form of their carbonates, sulfates, chloride and fluorides. So here again you can rhyme this MacDonald Epsom car. So from there magnesite, dolomite, Epsom salt, carnelite, then limestone, gypsum, fluorspar. The next is aluminium, tin, lead and mercury. So here we are having, for this aluminium I have just made this like ABCD KFC. So you can easily memorize this as ABCD and KFC. KFC, you very well familiar with this. So here A stands for aluminium, so that we come to know this is for aluminium ores, right? So first is your, this B relates with the box, and this C stands for corundum, but it is better to memorize this in this manner, because through this you can relate the formula also. It would be better to memorize if you really want to memorize these chemical formulas also. So here aluminium ores, bauxite, corundum, diaspore, kaolin, feldspar and cryolite. So bauxite is Al2O3. As I told you in the first slide that aluminium is present in their oxides. So here you can see all are oxides. These are silicates. We are having aluminium like this in the form of oxide. Aluminium is present in the form of oxide. So from there it will be easy for you to relate the formula. Bauxite is having Al2O3 2H2 and diaspore Al2O3H2O. Then corundum, drop this H2O also, Al2O3. Now cryolite. Cryolite is very important when we are doing the extraction of aluminium metal. Cryolite is used as an impurity while we are extracting the aluminium from bauxite, just to reduce its melting point. Since alumina is having high melting point, if we added this cryolite to that aluminum, then the melting point of that alumina reduces up to 900 degrees centigrade. So this cryolite is very important, cryolite Na3LF6, how these two are related with each other. So here is the feldspar. It is found in the form of gangues. So it is alumina silicate. Feldspar is the alumina silicate and it is in the form of gangue present in most of the ores. Right, and this on reaction with water, it turns into clay that is termed as kaolin. So here, the clay, feldspar, mica, these all are minerals of alumina. So ABCD, KFC, either you can memorize this in this term or BDCC, FK. So it is little bit difficult, but if you really want to memorize these formulas, then this is important. If you only want to memorize the names, then this is okay. Thin stone in the form of oxide, this is also known as cassiterite. So here it is thin oxide, lead as galena, PbS, mercury as cinnabar, and other ores I do not summarize over here because in most of the exams only question comes from these ores. So here, how you can relate these. So in the previous slide, I told you that you remember this fluorspar and feldspar. So the difference between these two is this is for aluminium and this is for calcium. The next is here we are having manganese, zinc and iron. So for manganese, it is pyrrole Mn. For manganese, it is pyrrole Mn. So why I have written it in this manner? So in the starting, we do not have Mn. But at the last, we are having M. So through this, we can memorize this, that this is the ore of manganese. And this is manganite. And this is pyrolusite. So here, why I have caps this O? Because through this, I can memorize this chemical formula. So this is pyrolusite is oxide of Mn. And manganite and their chemical formula are MnO2, Mn2O3, 2H. Next is zinc. So zinc blend, calamine, jinsite. These three you need to memorize as such, or you can relate this GGC. GGC. So zinc blend, so zinc sulfide, jinsite, zinc oxide, calamine. Calamine is used as a base of in the cosmetic industry. The next is iron. So how to memorize this iron? So here I have written like this: hamet, lemon, magnet, side. By iron pyrite. So from here we come to know that there is iron, right? Hamet. So it is, you can relate helmet. You just try to visualize this, that there is a table. On that table, a helmet, lemon and a magnet is kept over there randomly. So you keep them side by using iron pyrite. So hamet, hematite, lemon, lemonite, magnet, magnetite, side, siderite, and iron pyrite. So from here we come to know this, these all are the ores of iron and their chemical formula Fe2O3, again Fe2O3, 3H2O, Fe3O4. So what is the difference between hematite and magnetite? This is magnetic in nature. So Fe3O4 is magnetic in nature, whereas Fe2O3 is non-magnetic. Fe3O4 is magnetic in nature and it is concentrated by the magnetic separation method. Siderite, it is in the form of carbonate, iron pyrites. So pyrite is in the form of sulfide. One important thing why I have highlighted this magnetite and magnetite, since we are having three different ores which are having almost similar kind of names. So magnesite, magnanite, magnetite. So here this is the ore of magnesium, here this is the ore of manganese, and magnet, it is the ore of iron. In this way you can relate the next ores are copper, silver and gold. How to memorize this copper ores? So here I have made a mnemonic for this, cup of CpCg for azumar. So from here Cu, copper. So copper, so cup is there so that you can relate ores are of copper. So copper cuprite, Cp, copper pyrite, copper glands, azurite and malachite. So here copper oxide, copper glands, silver glands, these two are sulfides, Again, pyrites are in the form of their sulfide. Copper pyrite, copper iron sulfide, malachite, copper carbonate with copper hydroxide, azurite, copper carbonate with copper hydroxide. What is the difference? Differences of this two only. Silver glands, horn silver. So silver chloride is known as horn silver. Silver sulfide is known as silver glands. And there are one more ore was also there for gold. Since we have discussed that gold is found most of the time in its native form, but it has ores also. So calcarite, that is the ore with tellurium, right? Gold with tellurium. So AuTe gold twice. So these are the 41 ores which we have summarized in this video. Please subscribe my channel and give me a thumbs up. And also write down in the comment section that which mnemonic you find the most funny and useful. Thank you all.